In today's video, I'm going to show you how to install Mobox and launch it from XFC4 desktop environment natively in Termux without using proroot. This way we will have Wine and Box64 installed in a very easy way, so we will be able to run Windows programs with better performance than in proroot. We will also be able to install graphic drivers like Turnip in a very easy way in case we want to run any game. As always, I have the steps written in my GitHub repository. Let's go to Termux native section on how to run Windows programs. The first thing we have to do is install Mobox. For this, we go to the link I left and follow the installation steps. We will have to copy a simple command in the terminal. We paste it and let the installation process begins. After a while, it will ask us if we want to install the new version of Mobox with WoW64 or the previous version with Box86. Select the new version and let the installation continue. Once the Mobox installation is finished, we can launch it with the command that appears on the screen. We are going to launch it to verify that the process has been completed correctly. We press Enter being the first option to start the Wine desktop. From here, we can launch any executable from the Explorer that opens, or we can install the graphic drivers like Turnip, depending on the GPUs we are using. I don't have much experience configuring Termux, so surely we can optimize the default performance, but to start with, I will only install Turnip. Now we close Mobox. We can close the Termux X11 application, and then in Termux, we press the 1 key to exit as the instructions on the screen indicate. Finally, we press the key to the right and enter to select cancel. Next, we are going to start the XFC4 desktop installed in Termux native, not proroot. If you do not know how to get to this point, you have it both in my GitHub repository and in the video that I show you below and that I leave in the video description. Take a look at it, and if you have any problem, leave it in the comments. To launch the desktop, we use the script that I leave in the repo. When we have started the desktop environment, we will proceed with the download of the script needed to run the Mobox Explorer from here. I recommend to open the repository from the Termux desktop to make it easier. Go to the section I indicate and copy the first command to download the script to launch Mobox. Do it in the download folder. If it does not exist, just create it. We give run permissions to the script we just downloaded. Remember to leave it in the downloads folder. Now we copy the command to open the Mobox Explorer. In the video, there was a bug that I have already fixed. We simply have to run the script we just downloaded adding Explorer. This way we can open the Mobox Explorer whenever we want to run .exe files. Here's how to navigate to the download folder through Wine's File Explorer. From here, we can choose any .exe file to run or install. Keep in mind that not all programs will work properly, and there will be many that will fail. Later in the video, I leave you some tests that I have done. As a quick test, I have run Undertale, which is a game that hardly needs any resources to run, and it works without any problem. Now let's create a desktop shortcut to launch the Explorer we just opened without running commands. We go back to the repository and copy the following command. Note that we have to copy it when we have moved to the desktop folder so that it appears in the right place. If you do not have the folder, you will have to create it. Finally, we double-click on the icon that has been created and select the option Mark as an executable. We double-click again on the icon and the Explorer will open as we have seen when we have executed it from the terminal. Now I leave you with some tests I have done. The first one was to try to run Photoshop, but I didn't succeed because the application wouldn't start no matter how much I clicked on the .exe file. Then I tried the game Balatro, which I highly recommend. However, the performance was not very good even though it is not a game that requires a lot of resources to run. In the upper left corner, you can see the FPS at each moment. Finally, I am going to install Steam. In other tests I did previously, I was able to install and run Steam without problems by downloading the installer for Windows from the official website. However, this time I could only run the installer and install Steam, but I could not launch it because it ran minimized and failed when trying to open it. Anyway, I leave the process of how to install and how to find the program and has completed the installation as in any Windows PC will be in the folder called Program Files. So look there the programs that have been installed in Mobox to be able to launch them later. I hope you like the video. Leave in the comments what programs you have tried with this method, or which ones have failed.